In the event of a no-fly zone over Ukraine, the F-22 Raptor stealth fighters could sanitize the skies within an hour, but they are not deployed to Eastern Europe. Here's why. In the lead-up to Russia's invasion of Ukraine, the US Air Force deployed several of its aircraft to Eastern Europe. F-16s deployed to Romania, F-15s went to Poland, and F-35s landed in Germany. As the invasion first unfolded, F-35s from Germany were deployed to NATO's eastern flank, including Romania. According to Air Force magazine, a B-52 also deployed to the region around the same time, as part of what US Air Force call a long-planned Bomber Task Force Europe mission over the Arctic and Baltic Sea regions. One aircraft the US Air Force did not deploy to Eastern Europe to deter Russia is the F-22 Raptor. Why? What if the US Congress had never passed the Obey Amendment and export of the F-22 Raptor had not been banned? The matter of exporting the jet still stirs strong opinions more than a decade after Congress made it impossible to do so for fear of the secrets of the aircraft's many sensitive components and capabilities leaking out. What makes the F-22 Raptor so good? The F-22 Raptor is a single-seat, twin-engine stealth tactical fighter aircraft that can operate in any type of weather. It was produced by Lockheed Martin. It's worth noting that some of the main parts of the aircraft, like the wings and the training systems, were provided by Boeing. It made its first flight almost 24 years ago on September 1997 and was officially introduced in 2005. Since then, 195 Raptors have been built and currently, 8 of them are in testing while the other 187 are fully operational and in service. While in development, the primary role of the F-22 was to operate as an air superiority fighter. Its modern technologies, though, provide it with much more capabilities like ground attack and electronic warfare. Although the F-22 hasn't got into action yet, it is widely believed that it's the most advanced and capable superiority fighter that's ever existed. Since its introduction in the Air Force, it dominates in aerial exercises and has spread interest in other nations' armies. During its first years serving in the Army, a lot of problems occurred and a lot of research was needed. One example is that many pilots flying in the aircraft were observed to have a variety of common health issues. After several changes, mainly in the oxygen supply systems, the issues were eventually solved.